please extend our gratitude to the President by allowing us to utilize national government asset. I'll just present you simple details of the plan. Nakakatakot kasi first time. Ano lang namin kami dito? PLL. Partido Lakas Loob. Talagang lakasal ng loob. Because we cannot give up. Hindi tayo susuko. We'll continue to create. And thanks to Director Gap, I would like to the Architect Lichauco, si Dr. Eric, yun yung mga na anuan namin, na pagtanungan namin, no? Nagkonsulta rin kami sa kanila. But as you can see, no? This is the perspective. Initially, makikita ninyo, this is a 4,402 is available square meter. Usable square meter. That will compose of, that will add 336 mild and moderate. And it will house about almost 200 medical frontliners here. And as you can see, there is enough space on the left side and sa right side. Ibig sabihin, no, in the near future, it's scalable. So it can go as far as additional 100 or 150 bed later on. But for now, with the challenge ahead of us, this is something unique. This is the first time that we're going to do. We are very knowledgeable in building quarantine facility. Ang partner namin ng DPWH, no? Marami kami nagawang quarantine facility nila, Vice Mayor. Madali magtayo ng quarantine facility, but this is something unique because this is a hospital setting. Kaya all things are being considered. And I hope as we progress, Secretary Loresana, those people who are specialists can share their idea. So this is the perspective during daytime. No? The area is about 2.8 hectares. So this is the night perspective, no? It will be lighted, and thanks to Cecil, maaliwalas naman, magiging maaliwalas sa gabi. Kasi sa gabi rito, anong araw, alam mo naman dito, maraming gumugulong-gulong sa damuhan. Mukhang si Dr. Opas, natatawa, nakaka-relate eh. Mukhang nagulong ka rin sa damuhan dito ng araw. Ha? So, now, as you can see, no? Okay. Yung gitna will be all our nurse station. As per advice of Architect Lichauco, the nurse station must have a visual of the patient, no? Across the ward. So, mahiwalay natin yung male ward at yung female ward. At lahat ng ito, bawat ward, or the entire area will have a CCTV room which we monitor 24/7, telecommunication which is through intercom, internet connectivity, air conditioning unit. Ang ginawa namin para maging cost efficient, window type of air conditioning, no? Para pag nag-fail yung isa, marami pang pwedeng magamit at mapalitan. Hindi kami gumamit ng centralized air conditioning because, one, it's very expensive. Two, it's highly complicated. Three, high maintenance. And there is danger na pag may sira, malasaw na ba itong container sa init. Pagka, kaya kailangan yung environment must be sustain, no, in a livable environment, no. And also, we have, as you can see, the design. Yung labas na nakikita niyong below, ito po yung oxygen area. So what we did, instead of piping, doing the entire 4,000, doing piping the entire 4,402 square meter, ang ginawa namin, kung nasaan yung bed, nandoon ang butas noong dingding at nandoon yung oxygen, and when we're going to refill it, we're going to refill it outside. We don't have to send people inside like nowadays in the hospital. The people who are delivering it, they have to go all the way inside the hospital and the supply room. Nobody can go inside the facility as limited as possible. And of course, the fire alarm system, comfort rooms, ito pala, may istorya kami ng kaunti, base na rin sa mga napagtanuan, hiniwalay din namin yung banyo ng lalaki at paliguan ng lalaki. When we say hiniwalay, hindi separate room, literally separate wing. They have each wing will have their own bathroom and comfort room, no? Then of course the electrical system, the electrical wirings will be on raceway para mas mabilis. Ito yung ginagamit na concept kapag nagtatayo ka ng server room, no? So now there will be 336 bed and scalable 24 bed scalable for on top of 336 COVID bed, 24 beds will be for male quarters and 24 beds for female quarters. And meron silang area, pakita mo, itong susunod. As, ito na yung area na, and I need, as we progress, I need some suggestion from DOH. But we thought, and we were told, no, ito yung mapping ng area, no? Meron tayo sa unahan, the first two wing will be moderate. And the remaining wings will be mild. The reason behind, moderate may change their physical situation ng mabilis. Talagang unstable. So once na elevate siya to severe from moderate, madali namin siyang i-exit kasi habang ina-unclog namin yung hospital ng mild and moderate, we are creating ICU setting. The city of Manila is going to build 60 ICU bed in our hospital to address severe and critical. Because as per doctor's advice, kailangan nila ng mga mechanized or equipment, no? So, doon namin sila i-elevate. Kaya nasa unahan sila. At yung nasa taas ay mga mild cases. And again, don't get me wrong. Yung asymptomatic, nandoon sa 910 bed capacity ng Manila. So, meron tayong asymptomatic, secretary, existing. Meron tayong COVID bed, 523 bed. COVID bed in our 6 hospital, then it will be unclogged by moderate and mild patient, at yun ang ilalagay natin dito sa field hospital. So magiging kompleto yung loop. So, and the logic behind it, why, Mayo, bakit hindi ka nalang maggawa nito sa hospital? One, there is no space. Two, mas high demand yung life survive, mas maraming pangangailangan na espasyo to survive and critical. And third, rare ang ating medical frontliners in terms of profession. Pulmonologists, infectious disease doctor, and special nurse. So ayaw na natin sila alisin sa hospital setting. But with mild and moderate, as per advice, it can be addressed by a regular doctor or physician and a regular NER. So, ngayon, kumpleto na po yung loop, Secretary Loresana. So, next will be the approach. Walang tambay. As in, literally, darating ang ambulansya, hindi para i-test. He or she is confirmed case na mild. So, yung ambulansya, idudot-dot na lang diretso sa entrada. Kaya hindi namin nilagyan ng anumang structure dito because this is not a place for visitors. This is not a place to bring probable and suspected. This is a place for confirmed with mild situation and moderate. No? This is the CCTV area for security. Security and 24/7 monitoring of patient utilizing technology and maximizing resources, or which is in this case medical frontliners. Sa laki po nito, it will consume a lot of mileage or foot mileage, no? So para hindi mapagod na mapagod, the patients are being monitored and they have in case intercom that they can use pag kailangan nila ng tulong. Pati sa banyo nga pala, Dr. Paz, naglagay tayo ng intercom sa banyo. Why? Meron palang ano yun. May logic yun, ha? There are instances. Magaling na yung pasyente, pagaling na. Pag-due na siya for release. Because of pressure, anxiety, and emotional challenges, madalas sa hindi, inaabot sa banyo, inatake sa puso. And only to find out 30 minutes thereafter, hindi siya na natinan. Sadly, died. These are incidents, no? And real situation. So, but with this telecommunication, they can grab that and, you know, things may be addressed in a way. So, it will be monitored by 24/7. The doping area, this is the donning. The donning is different from the doping area. Ngayon ko lang nalaman yun. Kagabi ko lang kasi, ano yung doping donning? Baka nag-a-addict kayo, doping. Yun pala, iba pala yun. It's an area naguhuba gamit ang mga doktor. No. Ito yung kanilang male quarters. We'll try to make it more habitable na parang hindi sila nakakulong. There's a sala, things will be put into right perspective, and the nurse station. At this is the quarters nila, nurse station. A few more slides. There you go. In the nurse station, pag nakita niyo yung visual, straight all the way. Visualize this. Nakita niyo itong gitna? Lahat yan. All the way there. Puro nurse yan. Facing the left side, facing the right side. Makikita niya lahat. Kaya ginawa namin symmetrical. Next. Ito ang itsura ng sa loob ng ward. So we'll put a hospital bed, non-mechanized, non-electrical, because electrical bed will be acquired by the city for ICU and all other respiratory equipment to create one bedroom ICU capacity. And our goal is 60. So, yes, ward siya. Hindi kay, tama kayo, Sec. Beans. Hindi kailangan ng tela. Kasi, mamonitor namin sila. May distance yung tama. Sa dingding, is there, kasi dati ginagawa push button. The problem with the push button lighting, yung easy structure, pag hindi napansin, no? Unlike ito, intercom, talagang interconnected yung bawat nurse station up to the admin, the guard, and so on and so forth. The works. And, yun. mga kaibigan, eh, ano po ito? Hindi siya madali. We need your prayers. Hopefully, medyo, it's a very complicated, because, Mr. Secretary, it's a hospital. It's like, I know you've experienced battles and wars, you know, this is kind of things that medyo complicated. But, may awan Diyos, makakaraos tayo. Of course, we thank you, Secretary Galvez, Secretary Loresana, Secretary Romulo, Secretary Dizon, Secretary Duque, and the team, the MMDA, for you helping the local government unit. We will continue to work hand in hand, and our goal is to finish this in 60 days. We will try to finish this in 60 days so that we can prepare Metro Manila for the next 5 months in a bad situation or in a not so bad but not so good situation for the remainder of the years with regard to COVID bed availability for our mild and moderate so that we can help the doctors and the nurses, the medical frontliners na hindi sila ma no? Yung COVID bed setting sa hospital. And we will try to equip them with proper equipment so that they can continue to serve in with efficiency but with the help of proper diagnostic machineries or equipment. And here, at least, we can help. May awan Diyos, sana marami tayong masurvive. No? And this also, yung mga hihingi sa amin, kung sakasakali meron pa kami, yung hihingi sa amin ng Remdesivir, you can access it here. Yung hihingi sa amin ng Tocilizumab. Welcome po kayo sa Maynila. So then again, Mr. Secretaries, Honorable Secretaries, please extend our gratitude to the President by allowing us to utilize national government asset. And rest assured that you, in IATF, and NTF, in our own little way, we will continue to synchronize our actions. We will continue to work hand in hand with you. I know it's challenging. There will be no perfect government. There will be no perfect plan in this type of situation. But rest assured to each and every one of you here, when we fail, babangon kami agad. We'll do it again. When we succeed, we guarantee you we'll innovate. We'll make it further and reach more if we succeed. We will be with you. Nobody will be left behind. We'll be there all the way. Kaagapay ninyo ang pamahalang lungsod ng Maynila. Maraming salamat po. Maynila.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong panonood. At kung hindi nyo pa napapanood ang iba kong videos, nandyan po ang previous videos at my suggestion. At huwag po ninyong kalimutan na i-click ang subscribe button para updated po kayo sa aking mga ilalabas. Hanggang sa muli, bye-bye!